throughout this area, dry season, there's no area here, there's no water here. So whenever they came here, our forefathers here give them this water to drink, and the water is very cold. So they use here as a resting place. So they call this town Humjibre. That means a resting place.
Western region of Ghana. In the community, first it was not all that great. It's a small community, but the job of occupation here was farming and nothing else.
Farmers, there are crops are yearly. This is so you can't rely on farming. And now, if you don't have money to farming, it's very difficult. Because when you go to the northern region, they have some machinery that they are using for planning the farms and whatever, but here you don't have it, so there's poverty here.
The children, most important thing, they don't have any work here to do, and the farming here too is not too much, because when you farm a lot, you will never have those who will be able to come and then purchase. And in the community too, I think the one basic, the parents have, they don't have money to cater for the children in the education one thing. So as soon as the child gets well educated or a bit, he says that's all, but that's not enough for all.
So one of my child, it always got malaria and it reduced blood. So every, about 3 months, I always send him to hospital. But sleeping under the mosquito net, he never ill. So in this health or GHEI have helped us a lot.
Health and education. Health, we started with reproductive health. So we did education on reproductive health. We did HIV and AIDS, family planning, and our focus was on women and then the youth. We also felt that even though in Ghana it was a taboo speaking about condoms, we had our teenagers becoming pregnant and also getting STIs. Then we had to do our condom distribution in a way that was different. We did what we call youth-friendly condom distribution.
HIV is one disease is current most of Ghanaians. So we started to educate how to prevent ourselves from HIV. The best thing you can prevent ourselves from that disease is condom use. So we have male and female.
Apart from this, we also do malaria education, and we have been distributing insecticide-treated mosquito bed nets for people in the community. And each year, we do what we call Malaria Day.
My activity, what I did always, is to distribute malaria prevention. And so I'm now distribute bed net to the whole community of Humjibre. I'm also collecting data. If I enter the house, I have to ask the total number of people that are sleeping there. And after that, I have to give you the education.
Because of the bed nets, they are no longer frequently taking ill of malaria, and it's helping them economically. To date, we have distributed, including the Surano project, close to 3,000 mosquito bed nets for people for free.
GHEI have helped us in the hand washing program. Already we had some oil basins here and some soap, but they came here to donate some oil basins and soap and towels to augment what we had here already.
When you come back or come down to the community itself that we are working in, they do appreciate all the work that we do, especially when we give them incentives like giving them soap for hand washing. When we do the deworming, we give them flip-flops, and it gives people encouragement to assist GHEI.
Education proper, we have what we call Youth Education Program, YEP, and under YEP, we select children from the government schools between 12 and 16 at a time, three classes that run each year, and these children, we give them supplemental English teaching.
As an organization, we don't go beyond government structured or constitutional law. So as we are in to help the community, we also try to limit ourselves to those who cannot afford to pay more for their children's school. So we don't deal with the private schools, but rather the public schools in the community.
We also do what we call Girls Empowerment Program. Say between now and the time that they actually gain admission to senior high school, there's the tendency of these girls refocusing their ideas or their interests, not on education, but on different things. We bring these girls together and then orient them for the future, but all directed to the fact that the higher you are educated, the more you are respected in community, so that we don't want girls in the rural area to be confined to the kitchen.
As a teacher, what I do with the children is to teach them how to write and then to read. They are too young, so at the ECL class, we have to teach them from the smallest to the biggest. And these people, we do it for those who are slow learners, so that they will be able to cope with their friends.
The organization is helping Humjibre based on the resources that they are putting, they are establishing in the community, like the library.
None of the schools have a library, so the library is purposely for all the schools in Humjibre and those surrounding villages to normally use their library.
Now we have about 4,500 books, and we open it from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m., then from 6 to 9 p.m.
Because of lack of funding, we are not able to help many of the deserving students, and we have limited sources of funding. So I will appeal to all organizations out there who are interested in education to help us.
As we are having the malaria, we used to use all the money we get, we spend it on what? The hospitals, curing our diseases. And through this, we are, saving the money to do something better, like putting down our own personal houses or community-based things, like even churches, and use the money to support or feed our children.
My last message to
to our people is this. One, they should encourage their kids to school. At least everybody should try to send his world or her world to school. That's, you see, now we don't have forest. So everyone should invest in education.
Doctors, engineers, lawyers, and all that. That's my dream. That's my dream. That this community will grow. Will grow in education, in everything. Administration of the community. And then the cooperation. The traditional side of it, aspect aside of it. Everything has grown up than my period.
Ma fe maya to bi chwala nwa sa.